hours since Skyway Shuttle service. We aim to make getting there half the fun. Please. The next shuttle is approaching the station. Last call for passengers. The shuttle is preparing to depart. Shuttle is approaching the station. Last call for passengers. The shuttle is preparing to depart. The next shuttle is approaching the station. approaching next station. If this is your stop, please prepare to disembark. Last call for passengers. The shuttle is preparing to depart. Please clear the hatch. Shuttle will be deployed. Your shuttle? Not a problem. Another call for passengers. The shuttle is preparing to depart.
Welcome to the ASOP Vehicle Retrieval System. Your insurance claim has been sent.
Thank you.
ASOP vehicle retrieval system. Your insurance claim has been sent.
Thank you. can't stay here. Yeah, yeah, friendly, 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 no problem. No problem, no problem. What did you say? What did you say, bro? I'm just here for to take some stuff and go to drop down. Yeah, yeah, your ship's still here. Your ship's still here. What did you say? Are you just on my mission, bro? Thank you.
Hey, Major One. Sorry, I was mute. What's going? Not much. I'm looting weapons so I can have gear. It's called shopping in Star Citizen. Why spend money when you can make money and get free gear? It's just... I mean, that's just how it is in video games, you know? That's okay, it's easy to forget the mic is mute. I did the same a few times by mistake, yeah. Well, also, I did have it mute on purpose because I didn't want to have any bleed-out audio with the music stuff going on, but lowered the music volume. It is a little too loud, let me know. The idea is just to get some free guns, so... Move all of the guns. I was going to take some free armor from the dead corpses, but the bodies despawn after a while, so you gotta be real quick about it. And then the AI respawned too, so I'm just like, eh, I'll do it some other time. Tonight, there will be another Siege of Orison event, which is the one I livestreamed on YouTube on Monday night. It's gonna be great. Now that I know what I'm doing, I can, like... But I don't have to follow people, I can do it on my own. Be nice. Although, of course, I'm gonna get the guys together. Close the door for safety. Not that this ship will really protect me any. But at least this way I won't get sniped. Oh! Okay. Gun's just gonna be... FS9s? No, there's a Karna in here, wasn't there? Or did I lose the Karna? I think I lost the Karna. Still, 3 FS9s is a pretty good haul. Some SMGs for CQC. We got a P4, which I'll just have to grab later, I guess, or... Not gonna let me grab it, I'm just gonna. They're easy to come by. Awesome, sounds fine, great. Everyone says, I really like the music you played the other day, it fit well with the game's action. Yeah, that's from, I was playing Half-Life music, so. Right now I'm actually playing Star Citizen music. Drop this crap off at LSR. Drop the stuff off. Looks like my character's getting a little thirsty. I have water at LSR as well, so that's good. What job to do next? Keep it Merc work. Guarding against hostiles didn't work out. Back up. This pays well. And there's. I'm more concerned with money and loot than anything right now, so. Actually, I don't need to, here. All right, Megazetti, because you're watching, I'm gonna go laser weapons because I know you like the lasers. Space station looks like an old Starfleet station. It is an old, it's a placeholder station that they do plan on removing at some point. So it does fit that aesthetic of it will no longer be there soon. Try some laser weapons. I have some laser weapons. These. Set off. Ooh. I have glasses on. I have fancy schmancy glasses on. Someone's making this. Pop out the glasses. Keep my fancy schmancy glasses safe. All this crap. Need things I would certainly need. I have a laser pistol. Let me get one of those. Sell the oxygen pens at some point, so remember to do that. Sell the knife too. Alright. Measure One says, I recently made a new channel on YouTube to post my Evil Dead content. Nice. What's the name of it? Actually, no, I'm sorry, I did the wrong, I responded incorrectly there. I believe the proper response would be Groovy. But Evil Dead is a pretty cool franchise. I'm glad they're it's getting some love again with that new game, but I hear the game is absolute dog shit. The Grateful Deadite, heh. The only Grateful Deadite is a dead Deadite. What colors? What colors are what? The laser? They're red. In this game, lasers, I mean, they're sci-fi laser weapons, not real life laser weapons, but... Oh, I forgot to get water. That's alright. Laser weaponry, there's three types of weapon types for FPS combat. Got laser. Sorry, no, there's three types, and then each type has like three different whatever. So with energy weapons, you have laser, plasma, and electron. With ballistics, it's just going to be the different calibers of bullets and eventually different ammo types, like high explosive, incendiary, armor-piercing, etc. But really, you split it up into two. There's ballistics, energy, and then energy and ballistics have variants of themselves. If that makes sense. On here. Major One says, I enjoyed the game, but there are some issues. Problem is that when we tell them what the problems are, they update it to make the problems worse. They give us the opposite of what we asked for. Yeah. I've seen, I think, one video of gameplay, and it looked like just a visual mess of what was going on. Like, I couldn't tell what was happening, which in of itself is an issue. But it was... Like, what, is it one of those games where there's a lot of heavy monetization in them? Or, cause I know it's a asymmetrical multiplayer, which sounds good on paper, but of all games, Evil Dead, that's like, I would love a PvE version, where there's no multiplayer, what the hell? Yeah, for instance, I'm not getting the game because it's PvP, because it's just, that means one side has to be the Deadites. I'd much rather one side being, the Deadites being the AI, and the, but players are always whatever cast, you know, Ashen crew of various eras or whatever. Like, maybe have a multiplayer PvP option, right? Like, as an option, as an add-on, not as the main focus. I feel like that's kind of... that's where they lose me. Because I'm not a huge competitive multiplayer guy, at least not anymore. I used to back in the Halo days, but even then, I wasn't that competitive. But nowadays, I definitely... Not, what do you mean nowadays? Who am I kidding? I've always been co-op focused. I rather have me and my friends versus AI versus me and my friends versus more of my friends or some other people. Because it's just more fun. More fun to just play as a team, even... Like, yeah, there's that competitive element, but that's why you have it as an add-on or like an option, not the main thing and the only thing. And you look at all the old school FPS games, right? Yeah. Before, like, right when multiplayer was a thing. You know, and you had, you know, Halo and Call of Duty and all that. It was all single player first. Multiplayer was just an add-on. Now it's the opposite. If you even get lucky enough to have the single player in the first place. He literally ran into his death. Now, one of the problems I have with FPS weapons in this, and with ballistic weapons in Star Citizen right now is that they're just better than laser, and that means you have no reason to use laser. Now, we'll have the damage type model, the new damage model later on, but it's like, they also, the way they kind of nerfed the visual elements of the laser, like the way the laser discharged. Like, go check out my Flickr and look at the screenshots from, like, the old screenshots. And you'll see some pretty badass laser firing, but nowadays... I feel like they just removed it because it was a removable feature that they can, like, okay. Well, there's not even a muzzle flash, really. And it's just a red... laser-looking bullet at this point. There's no unique visual element. And that kind of like... And the sound effects aren't that great compared to what they used to be. It just doesn't feel that satisfying to fire as the old ones did. But hopefully they rework all of that when they do the new damage model, but I'm not holding my breath. I'll keep the laser sidearm for now, but I'm probably going to use ballistic rifles. Everyone says, I lucked out getting the game pre-ordered for free. My pal, It's a Trap Productions. Oh, how is that? It's a Trap Productions, by the way. Posted a free giveaway, free game of your choice, and I surprisingly won, so I requested the pre-order. Because I got it pre-ordered, I got the Gallant Knight Ash and S-Mart Ash skins for Army of Darkness. Only skin I missed out on was Sivani Ash, but sadly it doesn't bother me because while Sivani does great designs, his Ash wasn't as good as Sivani Jason. Okay. So, but that answers my question, that they are monetizing the game through skins. So there is a monetization element to it, which is, I mean, again, it's a typical game these days. Like, just only multiplayer, follow all the monetization trends. It's why I always predict shit and then I'm turned out to be right, because the industry as a whole has become so predictable because they're just following the same trends and it's like cannibalizing itself. Oh, here are some of the ballistic pistols. Grenades. Or granadas. or danger pineapples, as I've heard them. I've heard them referenced as. I don't know where that ballistic pistol. Oh, hey! A shotgun! Oh, I should check the security office. There might be loot in there. Definitely not the first person here today. Oh, I have the gun in my hands, that's why. Wait. This is the S-38 surface sidearm. Actually, no. Let's look at it. Just look at it here. Like it's just—it's a typical ballistic weapon, but it's more satisfying to fire. It feels good to shoot. Assuming CIG is even watching any of this. Get on that. Fix the weapons. FPS combat's important too, it's not just the ships. Eh, I think we're done here. Unless there's any boxes up here. Yep. He's doing good? Good. Glad to hear that It's a Trap Productions is doing good. Everyone also says, while they do monetize the skins, they aren't too expensive. At least $5. $4.99. Dude, to me, anything above 99 cents is too expensive. And you just said you pre-ordered, like, it's not a free game, correct? This is a game you have to pay for to get. Like a game you purchase at a flat fee premium price. If that is the case, it should not be monetized at all. Again, that's just how I think, but I know that many other people agree with me on that. And I still, like, you should not be monetizing assets in the game. If you want to monetize the game, it's like the game as a whole. Yeah, great, it's an art form. You're selling a piece of art, this $60 or $40 game, whatever it is, because the game has value. The game has value in the real world. Assets and items in the game do not. I don't like that they've been monetizing it to hell, because it's also it models the industry as a whole. Hold on a sec. Sorry about that. But, like, what I was getting at is the monetizing the games, because you see it's successful, because there are people that either don't care, can't control themselves because they must have it, right? Or just get caught by the predatory gameplay loops that are designed to make you spend more money. Kind of fit. And the problem with, as I said, like, it affects the entire industry when they do this, because now every game's doing it to follow that successful trend, because, oh, it's marketable, right? It's financially successful. And you see it done more and more and more. I'll come back and get this stuff. But the problem is that you have that, and it's like, okay, EA starts monetizing the fuck out of all their sports titles back in the day, right, when they first started doing it. And it's successful, wildly successful. Okay, then other companies see it and start doing it. And now you have games designed around the monetization, because that's where we're at today. They're not designing the games and then adding the monetization because they think they can make their buck. They're making the games with monetization in mind. And if that hurts the game, so be it. They don't care. Benjamin says, I technically didn't pre-order it. It's a trap, did I just get the skins? I know, I'm not trying to say like you can't enjoy it or whatever. No, you do you. You have fun. I'm just saying that I'm just pointing out how it is, just how it is. You know, like it hurts the fact that these games do this hurts the industry because now it's not about what creative, new, innovative way can we make this game and have engaging content for the player, right? For the customer. You know, what can we do to get them to keep coming back? It's now, how can we further milk them and milk their wallets? It's no longer about good content. Also, can I put this on the... No. It's the same exact thing as in the movie industry and TV shows and comic books. Like, I mean, different reasons, but like the same... The result is the same, where... You now have some extremely, why am I blanking on the term here? I guess neglected? That's not the term. Disgruntled, that's the term. I don't know why it took me so long to figure that to remember. You have a lot of disgruntled customers, essentially, and a lot of them feel neglected because, like, hey, instead of making good products that keep people coming back because you keep making good products, right, you're just trying to take advantage of the customer. And in many cases, like, the whole brand loyalty stuff, you're taking advantage of that to make more money. And that's always been the case, I know. None of this is new, it's capitalism, right? But there was still art involved. Like, if you look at a game from 10 plus years ago, that's a piece of art. Same with a movie, or a TV show, anything. These are all art forms. They're different types of art forms, but they're art forms nonetheless. But now it's all just corporatized and homogenized crap. A lot of the games are just cookie cutters of the same shit every year. And the Evil Dead game itself is just like a reskinned version of the Whatchamaface, right? Sorry, not the Evil Dead game. I'm confusing the Friday the 13th game. And the Predator Hunting Grounds game. Those are just reskinned versions of each other, aren't they? Made by the same people. And the games are both asymmetrical, where you have essentially a seemingly unkillable monster as one player, who, in the case of Hunting Grounds, is literally an unkillable monster because of how broken that game is. But it's, to me, it's... Maybe I'm just an old man complaining, but I really do, like, wish for the old gaming deck where it wasn't just greed everywhere. I know what I'm saying is kind of a laugh because, yeah, you know, it's always monetized. Everything's good. But, I can just hear people saying, like, oh, but Mando, the corporations always want money. That's their whole thing. Yeah, that's right. But there's good ways of going about making said money, and there's bad ways of going about making said money. And what they're doing right now is bad. Whether it's successful, like, yeah, it's financially successful. Look at EA made $1.62 billion alone last year from just their from their ultimate team mode, from their loot boxes. From one game mode, across their various sports titles, but in 1 year, from one specific monetization method in these games, they made $1.62 billion in revenue. Insane. Disgusting. Can you imagine having that much money? Sorry, I'm behind on chat right now. I know that. Let me just get inside. Ooh, nice sunset. Or sunrise. I think it's a sunset, though. Hard to tell when you're in space. Background while I catch up on chat. Everyone says, I'm just glad they didn't monetize the new Castle Kandor map. If they did that, that would have been ridiculous. No, I'm surprised that they didn't. At least the Evil Dead skins are in packs. Example, upon release, the first pack was college skins for Evil EV1 Ash and Scotty, okay. And we've got everyone saying, I know and I appreciate it. I just want to set it right. Oh yeah, no, all good. I wanted to set the record straight too. I didn't want. That's why I'm like, no, I'm not. Don't want to bash on you, because what did you do? You didn't do anything. Literally, you didn't do anything. You got the game for free. That's the way you do it. Money or nothing. Chips are free. Everyone else says Alien Isolation was good content. Only a handful of DLC, but not completely necessary. Are you up until 2021? I never played the DLC. Well, that's not true. That's not true. I had the Nostromo pack. Because when I got the game, the night of release, I got the game, and it came with the Nostromo pack. But that was it. It didn't come with any of the other DLCs, especially since a lot of them came out afterwards. And that was the version of the game I played for up until 2021, for 7 years. And now I have access to all the DLC and everything on PC. It's like, this is great. But I was able to replay the game annually for 7 years, no problems, enjoying the fuck out of it, pardon my French, without the DLC. Yeah, that's what a DLC is. It's not necessary, but it does add to the game, but it's not necessary. That's what good DLC is. That's just what DLC is to me. Like, you don't need the DLC to enjoy this game, because the game's made, it's a solid experience, the DLC just adds to it. Major1 also says, yeah, the games from 2000s may not have been high-res realistic, but they were perfectly made despite their graphics. Honestly, I like some of them in spite of their graphics. I mean, yes, they're not photorealistic and all that, but you know what? in a lot of modern games, I think the Mortal Kombat 11 specifically, at least when it comes to faces, the photorealistic graphics thing makes it worse. Like, I enjoy the old, like, to me, I'm not a huge graphics guy, too, so that, you know, I'm a little bit biased in that I don't care if it's Star Citizen pretty or, you know, Halo CE pretty. As long as I can see what I'm doing, that's all that matters. Because at the end of the day, it's a video game, but, you know, I'm not buying it because of graphical fidelity, I'm buying it because I want to have a good time doing whatever. What the fuck? Speaking of graphics, there's just a guy out there, and he's not in a spacesuit. How is he alive? Anyway, Vegemon 1 says, at least Predator and Evil Dead give survivors a chance to kill the monster. Friday the 13th requires specifics, and one screw-up can't be done. Yeah, but I think... And you're right, but all three of them have failed. Like, and I'm not saying the concept of a asymmetrical multiplayer is just wrong, it should never be done. No, I think there is a good way to do it. I just don't think we've seen that yet. Because what happens is the Predator becomes way too OP, and from what I've heard, the gunplay in the Predator game is horrible. As you said, the Friday the 13th one is... pretty much, honestly, I feel like that's not actually a bad system because it requires teamwork, and if you guys aren't coordinated, you are fucked. Megumon says, I still say that despite all of GTA 5's vast open world, San Andreas was better because it felt big with its cities. Yeah, and you know why? Because it was denser. You can have the biggest map in all of gaming, but if it's not packed with stuff to do, what's the point? And my map, I mean like a city map, like, you know, Grand Theft Auto or whatever. Or, like, let's take, the reason why Spider-Man games always only do Manhattan, and even then they only do, like, two-thirds of Manhattan at best, is because of engine limitations. They can't have a giant city and allow you to do everything at the same time. But even so, like, a lot of open world games suffer from this, where it's like, oh, we're gonna make the world bigger and more open and larger maps and blah blah blah, but there's still the same shit to do if that shit is even in the game. It's just, it becomes a big open empty world as opposed to just a world for you to explore. That's why I love Assassin's Creed Revelations. It's my personal favorite of the entire franchise, because Constantinople in that game, Istanbul, is so dense. It's a smaller map than Brotherhood, but it's so dense, it's full of character, the story is great too, and it's also not one of the big Brotherhood is in Rome, and much like, you know, it's not a big city. Like, it's not a big popular historical city that everyone will go, oh yeah, that city, blah blah blah, Rome, you know, Roman Empire, this, that. Like, no, this is Constantinople. It has a rich history, but I liked it for that. I liked it that it was smaller and it made use of that scale properly. Imagine one's asking, Mando, what's your favorite Evil Dead film? I think I'm gonna go with the first one. Like, I love the second one, and I love the ones after that, but the first one just has that charm and rewatch, and like the cheesy rewatchability of, that's just great. Megumon says, this reminds me of Shatner seeing a man outside the airplane. It's just, he's just standing out there chilling, literally, because, you know, it's space, it's cold. I'm sure he's fine. Mejimo says, one thing that's broken in the Evil Dead game, most PC players playing as the demon always win. They bully and kill you before you even get to the end of the match. I play as a demon and I never have it that lucky, even as I level up. At level 25, I only just won my first public match as Evil Ash and Necromancers. Why do you say... Because I have no idea even like what the combat system is. Is it because PC players have a mouse and keyboard as opposed to a controller, so they have better aim? Is that the type of argument? Because, again, I'm in the dark completely about this game, aside from what we've gone over so far. I'm not accusing all PC players, but one of the game... my game pals who are on PC and use cheats and hacks calls them PC peasants. Oh! I mean, if they're using hacks, then obviously, yeah, but if they're not using hacks... Because there are some cases where having crossplay for PC and consoles is... Like, there is a disparity between the two. On PC, you have mouse, which is easier for aiming. Although I say that... Let me rephrase it. It's easier, objectively, easier for aiming. But that's not the case for everyone. Some people have an easier and even better time aiming on controller and can outplay PC players that way. That's just how it is. Of course, there are cases where that... You know, they're outpacing PC players because of aim assist, but... My point being is that it's different for everyone, but having a mouse does allow you for better control. My character is hungry, so are you? Bell, crap, and my backpack. Not my backpack, sorry, my legs. Armor.
Feel free to take a look around. We've got a pretty good selection.
Do you remember how many oxygen pens I had? I don't. Okay, there we go. Seems we had 7. Opium. Why are you selling opium? Medicinal opium. You know, for treating wounds. Junior pen, med pen. I'll keep these. Oh wait, I didn't make any money. Oh shit, I just realized that. Fuck. Alright, well, they're out of my inventory. They're not taking up space. That's fine. L.
We've just received some exciting new products.
Where is that knife? Sell that knife. Oh, here. I can sell the oxygen pen. Personal weapons. F. Leave F A S. Oh, the FS9. There we go. FSK. I do love that they added that search function. It makes things so easy. Really? That's a whole damn pistol. You're only gonna buy it for 4 creds? I feel like I'm being, dipped. Alright, how much are you selling the ammo for? Alright, 4 creds for ammo I can take. But for the entire gun, that seems like a scam. Hey. Also, the music is getting... It seems loud for me, but I have no idea if it's loud. But I'm gonna lower it anyways. Supposed to be background music, not blaring, orchestral, cinematic, whatever. Uh, Everyone says, oh, I'm missing a lot. Okay, hold on. Alright, the game has crossplay, but some have aimbot and likely hack the skill upgrades as they spawn on you and leave traps near your dead allies, so any attempt to revive them is a waste. Any players are cheating. I say the devs need to install an anti-hack bot to prevent hackers from cheating. They don't do jack. I agree that devs need to do something about it, but use like easy anti-cheat and all that stuff, they don't do anything. They actually hurt the game more than they protect it. Because a lot of those anti-easy cheat stuff end up just acting and serving as a backdoor to your system in some cases. Not all the time, but in some cases. So it's not worth the risk. It's just stupid. There should be better... Because the problem is you're trying to preemptively stop something, but the way you're going about it is possibly opening doors for further problems. That's not how you do it. I don't know what the answer would be, but I know that's not the answer. Evil Dead does have some single player missions, but they are few, 5 at the moment, and they unlock the survivors for online play. Example, completing the third mission where Army of Darkness Ash fights hordes of Deadites unlocks Henry the Red from Army of Darkness. By the way, Army of Darkness is my favorite, but I do appreciate 1 and 2. I mean, they're all good, that's the thing. Like, it's not like, oh, this Evil Dead movie, you like that? Ugh. Like, first off, if you're ever doing that to someone, what the fuck's wrong with you? They're allowed to like what they like. If they're, you know, they're free to be an idiot. You don't have to judge them on it. Or you can judge them for what they like, but you don't have to insult them for it. But, the whole... I think it was a very solid series of movies. And I loved the TV show. I was so disappointed in, what happened. When, like, they just decided to end it. I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? The show was great! What am I looking for? Coda, I got ammo for the coda, right? That way. Oh, I still have the shotgun on my back. That's what I wanted to get rid of. Now get some water. I might go into Dumper's Depot to see if I can buy something there. Water, bulk, yeah, I'll buy some water in bulk in a sec. Bottle. Here. Major One says, I found EV1 to be, Evil Dead 1 to be not so silly, can be a bit disturbing. When Ash's sister and best friend melted in front of him at the end, having their blood splatter in his face and their, yeah. Oh, I'm thinking of... Okay, no, I was mixing up 2. So 2 is definitely a good... I don't know. Fuck it, I'm not on the ball right now, so... Critical weapons... Cycle between sizes? Guns... No, seems I cannot. Small artifact damage. What is the purpose of this? I'm just gonna buy these just to see what they are. I didn't realize you can buy the artifact fragments here.
I think you're going to be happy with that.
Also, I'm forgetting I can just quick buy. Alright, I need to see what. I have a shopping list here for ship parts. I think everything I need to buy is not here, so. Wait. With my helmet back on. Right, so what? I assume it was an other. Yep, here we are. Take a look at these things. What are these? Artifact, but of what? Wow, that is tiny. I wonder if Astropub knows about these. Get him that. Figure out what the hell these are. Up his alley. Did you look at this one yet? Oh yeah, we looked at this one. Not looked at this one. Same thing, but reversed or something like that. No! The strap! The UEE strap. That's pretty cool, though I question why Dumper's Depot of all places is selling. Actually, no, I don't question why it's of all places it should be selling them, but why are they selling them? Let me buy some more MREs so I have those in stock, and on to the next adventure. When you think about it, Ash lost his best friend, his girlfriend, and his sister, his hand. Nearly lost his sanity and got sent back to 1300 Europe in the span of a weekend. Like an alien do not disturb door sign. Yeah, that's probably what it is. Ash had it pretty fucking rough. Absolutely. Like, that, and that's what I liked about the show. Like, when you meet him in the show, like, you see what all of that's accumulated to, and it makes sense that he's the way he is in this show, because you look at what he's been through, and he's just doesn't give a shit anymore. So, yeah. Where can you even watch the show nowadays? I don't even know where it is. Is it still on Netflix? Buy some more ammo for this bad boy.
Good purchase.
Just realized I bought all the MREs to my backpack. Don't want that. You want that. Let's go. I think my ship's still there. And what, research mission? Got a lot of mercenary work. Well, we can go back to Korea. Or we can punch some boxes. The Korea mission's still up after the boxes, we'll go there. Yeah, I watched it when it was on Stars 2. That was back in, what, 2016? I remember seeing the original announcement shit and everything at Comic-Con. Some cool stuff. Speaking of TV shows, I need to catch up on Orville. I'm up to episode 8 or 9. Really been enjoying the third season so far. Bogies. I'm not in a ship prepared to take on a freelancer miss. I have no weaponry. I have weaponry. I have no shields, really. I cannot take hits at all. If I can fire at this guy, I will do it, but oh, there's a whole fucking squad there. Aegis Gladius and the Avenger Stalker. Oh, firing missiles. If I can get them close enough, actually no, like they own that place, though. Problem. I have missiles of my own though. I don't know what happened to my weapons however, so we're... My weapons are still on the ship visually, but they wouldn't fire. Not firing. That's not good. I shall return in a better ship. Did to release the safety lock. If only. There's power to the weapons. I don't know what's going on. Actually, where is my ship? Ship I want to bring out. I could bring out the Carrick, but I don't have turret gunners, so... Fly out to Cruel 1 and get my Cutlass Black. I haven't used it in a while anyways, so this will be... Oh, now my weapons work. That's fantastic. I'm still not going to fight in this thing, though. That's just a suicide note. I arrived in Pisces. Kill me. That's what it says. It's a great ship, but it's not for combat. Despite it being a military shuttle. It's meant to get out of there fast, not meant to go into dogfighting. The guns are more so for laying suppressing fire rather than actually killing your target. That's cool, Major. I got, Major says, I gotta say, I am enjoying the Dragon Ball Xenoverse games. I may even get the recently Dragon Ball Z Kakaro game. Whatever floats your boat, man, right? Enjoy. I have not played any of the games, so I cannot judge. Crimes committed. Don't have that much money compared to what I used to have. Oh goody, the station's still a few hundred kilometers away. Come on. Let's say a few hundred, I mean a few dozen, 30,000 kilometers. Why is it dropping me off 30,000 kilometers? Later L1. Hangar. I'd much prefer a pad, but once we do the hangars, we'll do the hangar. Doors are still opening.
stay.
Store the Pisces, and before I get the cutlass block out, let me retrofit it with stuff. Back weapons, they're gonna be basic weapons, but it'll have to do. Replace them with anything? Weapons to replace them with. At least I can upgrade the shields. Stick with this for now, because the problem is I need more power to properly outfit everything. I don't have the quadricell yet. Save it.
Welcome to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system. Vehicle selected. Stand. Your vehicle has been delivered to the following.
Quick while I'm here. Hyper here. Start up here.
You are clear to launch.
A lot heavier than what I was flying before.
Thank you, and please visit again.
She's also a lot faster. At least when it comes to quantum travel. Brakes on. At least I can log out of this shit. There's my weapons. They're probably not going to be there anymore, but I don't care. At least now I have a better ship. Turrets are going to be hostile. Huzzah. Yep, nope. Bad landing spot. Ah, come on. Oh, that's not good. And now I'm blocking out. And now I'm dead. What's this about DC news? Get a nice view, and in 20 minutes, Siege of Orson should start. Part of me just wants to hang back at the bar, maybe run an ad, and wait for Siege of Orson. But I need to go back to Port Alistar to get some gear to bring it down here anyway. And if we have time, then I'll hang out at the bar. Want to bring a snooper whistle.
Miss your shuttle? The next shuttle is approaching the station.
Oh. Early. Right in the proverbial nick. FS9s I'll run into at the event, so I'm not super concerned about those. I did have an extra coda on the station that I want to bring, along with some. Fun idea though. I guess I'll have to try. I'll try it tomorrow. We'll get a one SCU crate and we'll bring it with us to Siege of Orson and use it as mobile cover. It'll be like bringing a riot shield that can cover three people at once.
clear to launch.
I think I'm going to end the stream here as I fly out to orbit, because I will start a new stream when Siege of Orson goes live in like 10 minutes, 9 minutes. So just gonna be dividing it into two different streams.
Hello!
Hello!